In May of 2004, after a long struggle with bipolar disorder, our son William ended his own life. He was a loving and much loved child. He was curious and interesting. He traveled with us to many countries. It seemed magical. When we moved to Washington, school was a real challenge. There was a succession of schools. There was bullying and then alcohol. Depression is a recurrent disease that can start in childhood and is the greatest cause of death in adolescence. Bipolar disorder is a particularly destructive form of depression that we still have a long way to go toward solving. I cannot attempt to describe the devastation of this loss. I found myself writing, "I know, at last he is at peace." My friend, Mary Lasker, used to always say, "What is missing and what is needed?" And that phrase became of paramount importance throughout my scientific life. Rather soon after William's death, I began to concentrate on ways to advance research in the study of the brain. I asked scientists across the country, what are the challenges in communicating across disciplines from sharing a rapidly growing base of scientific data about mental illness? These discussions caused me to reflect on ways I might possibly help by funding bold, imaginative, and even risk-taking research by the next generation of scientists studying anxiety, depression, bipolar, and other mood disorders. Fortunately, having served on the board of the Foundation for National Institutes of Health for 25 years, I knew where to ask and look for partners. The basic work for the Foundation for NIH was to help NIH advance science and fill in gaps. The Deeda Blair Research Initiative for Disorders of the Brain is a research awards initiative to identify and support the work of neuroscientists and researchers in psychiatry. It supports creativity, disruptive ideas to accelerate research in the causes, the care, and the treatment. An outstanding scientific selection committee was formed to guide our thoughts and review the awards. These individuals from outstanding academic institutions, leaders from industry, emphasized the need to focus the next generation, to think of a future and the gap between advances in basic neuroscience and clinical psychiatry.
The sort of work that I do may be considered risky. And what was so validating about the Deeda Blair Award is that it suggested that the work was not only sort of feasible, but also had a lot of scientific merit.
The award allowed me to think bigger and to think more creatively and to try some hard things just as I was defining what my lab was going to be. That's where this really made a big difference for me.
I am confident under the leadership of Julie Gerberding, the work of FNIH will contribute to the forging of new paths and further understanding of the brain.
There's no shortage of important questions in psychiatry. This funding is critical to making sure that we pursue as many important questions as possible.
Mental health research has been significantly underfunded. And at this time, when we're growing through a global public health crisis, it is of profound importance to act right now.